Okay guys, so I'm going to talk you through the starting procedure. Basically, this is the sparkle wheel that we have here. This is the factory one that comes with the Radical. Alright, so basically this is the kill switch. We have to start it up, wait for the car, make sure all the temperatures are good. Temperature is fine, oil temperature, water temperature is fine. Then we do the ignition. Alright, and then we start. Okay, we're good. To do the starting procedure, we push this button, clutch engaged, push the button, and downshift. There we go. Ciao. such a beautiful car. Such an amazing, amazing experience. I love this. I live for this. So beautiful. Really. I live for this.
Moving fast, huh?
Beautiful. So beautiful.
Loving it, man.
I saw that slide.
You saw that? I'm trying to see how far I can go with the brake. I'm trying to see how late I can go.
Just do brakes.
Yeah, of course.
And
you can't overshoot the front.
Be careful. I wouldn't try that on one. Just...
It's funny you say that. That's where I was mostly trying.
No, I know. Only because...
It's a straight line.
It is straight, but you're coming...
Oh, man. So beautiful. So, so beautiful. What a machine. I want to take Gerald with me for a spin.
Oh my god.
He would freak out.
Dino would love it.
Dino would freak out.
Thank you.
These things are like little track weapons. They're amazing. So much faster than basically any of the road cars we have here. We have McLarens, we have GT350, Porsche, GT3s, Caymans, whatever you want. It's just in its own league. So yeah, things to talk about. It has a 6-point harness, and what's amazing about these things is they have a passenger seat. That's what I absolutely love, is that you can actually take people with you on track days. It's not like a single seater where it's like a Formula 3 or Formula 4 where you're just on your own, even though I love driving single seaters, and they do drive pretty similar to single seaters. What I was gonna say, yeah, the standard steering wheel that comes with it is the Sparco steering wheel. It comes with the paddle shifts. However, it is a sequential gearbox, and the paddle shifts are operated by an air compressor. You push this button here to start from neutral. You push this button here and downshift to select first gear, and then you can go. It does have a clutch. You do have to operate the clutch to basically leave with the car. That's the cutoff switch right there. So yeah, as I was saying, that's the cutoff switch over there. Normally, let's see here. You start the car. There we go. Okay, then we do ignition, and then we can start the car, and vice versa to turn off. That's to adjust the brake bias. Of course, that's for rain, and you have the dash, which is operated by an aim system, and that's the aim system right there that lets you know everything. That's the ECU. Really, really cool. Not as much carbon fiber as the SR3s, but still an incredible machine to drive. What an incredible machine to drive. Super fun, super reliable. The SR1s are probably the most reliable of the bunch, even though they don't have the upgraded suspension. And from the rear, these cars don't have a full-on transaxle. They're actually chain-driven. It has a sequential paddle shift with an air compressor in the back. Usually when you start it, you can hear the air compressor kind of pump. That's the compressor. That's what I was talking about. The compressor is air, so it fills up air to be able to shift the gears, and you can hear that in any of the radicals. And do not pull this. Do not pull this. There's a fire extinguisher right there, and the pin is removed. So cool. Such a tight cockpit. The SR1 is much more tight than the
daytime running lights.
Okay, so this is the option, daytime running lights.
Yeah,
because not all of them get this, because I noticed some of them don't have this.
Exactly.
So
yeah.
I was like, the makes sense. Don't mind me, I'm just filming.
Oh, no, don't worry.
He's used to it.
I'm on my hands and knees. Don't look at me like a foreign man. I'm Anthony. How you doing?
I'm Nabi. Nice to meet you, Anthony.
I'm sorry.
All right, Nabi.
Nabi.
Yes.
Where are you
pleasure.
From?
I'm from Jordan, originally.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, Middle East, yeah.
It's cool.
It looks funny looking to me. Like, I'm still trying to decide what...
Right.
Like, you know, those are more like LMP cars,
yeah.
Almost. This one's kind of like a hybrid. It's like a... So other than the roll cage, it's just the rear wing on the back?
I did a rear seat delay.
Nice.
These are new wheels.
Nice.
Those are Apex Racing wheels.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to run the carbon fiber wheels with the on the track, right? Is that why you did the change?
Well, no, this isn't an R.
Oh, okay, I thought it was an R.
No.
Fair enough.
It's actually better than an R.
Really?
Well, with everything I've done to it.
Fair enough, because really the R is just the same thing with the carbon wheels.
I've got four performance lowering springs put on it, the suspension, I got canards put on the front.
And you're enjoying it on the track?
Oh, yeah.
Such a cool car.
Yeah.
Enjoy it, man.
Yeah, thanks.
Awesome car. Yeah, this thing is so beautiful, baby. It's such a pleasure to drive.